In this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to install Windows 10 on your Mac using Bootcam Assistant. The first thing we need to do is to head over to Microsoft's website and download the Windows 10 ISO file, which will allow you to install Windows 10 on your MacBook using Bootcam Assistant. Here, you need to select the edition of your Windows 10 you want to install. Also, don't forget to read the system requirements before you begin. Now, click Confirm. Choose your language and click Confirm. Then you should see the 32-bit and 64-bit download options. You want to select 64-bit download option, and that will download the Windows 10 ISO and save it to your downloads folder. So once your Windows 10 ISO download completes, you can proceed to the next step. Let's configure the Bootcam Assistant. First, open Bootcam Assistant app. Click Continue. Now it should automatically detect the ISO file in Downloads folder. If it doesn't, you can click on the Choose option and select the Windows ISO image from the path wherever you have saved it on your Mac. And after doing that, we need to designate the amount of space you want to give the Windows Bootcam partition. You can hold this point and drag over to assign the space. Make sure you leave the macOS with enough space. I am giving it 100 GB of space, but if you're planning to play games on Windows, you might want to give it a little bit more space. So decide as per your preference. Once you have it set, you just need to click on the Install button. Make sure your MacBook is connected to a power source. Now you will see it downloading Windows support software. This is gonna take a long time, so please have patience. Now it's going to ask you for your MacBook password. I am going to provide the Touch ID. Now it's going to reboot your Mac and you're going to boot into Windows setup to install Windows 10. Now here, select language to install, time and currency format, and keyboard or input method. Once you have that filled out, click on the next. Now it's going to ask you for the product key. If you have one, fill it in here. If you don't, just click on I don't have a product key. Now you can select Windows 10 Home, Windows 10 Pro, or other available Windows versions from the list. I'm going to choose Windows Home for the purpose of this video and hit Next. Now click I agree and click Next. And then the installation process will begin. This takes much longer than I showed you here, so have patience. Now it's going to reboot your Mac and you're going to see you're getting everything ready. Now select your region and hit Yes. Select the keyboard layout and hit Yes again. Now I'm gonna skip this step, it's not much important. Now if you see your Wi-Fi network here, connect to it. I didn't see it, so I'm gonna skip this step and hit No. Now you have to input the new username. Then create a password for your new user account. And confirm the password. Now you have to select 3 security questions and save answers for them. You need to remember all these answers and it will be helpful for you to recover your lost password. Now here you can set up Cortana if you want. I'm going to skip this step for this tutorial and I'm gonna hit decline. Now I don't want to send any activity history to Microsoft, so I'm gonna say no. You can decide as per your preference. Here you can hit accept and go ahead, but I'm gonna turn off all the little personalization features and I'll turn them on whenever it is needed after installing Windows 10. Now click accept. And there we go. So we are at the Windows desktop and you can see the Bootcam installer is ready. This will install the necessary drivers for Windows to work with your Mac. So you want to click Next. Agree to the terms and click Install. It will start installing Bootcamp. Now click install on any other pop-up that you see. These are the drivers that you will need to work with your hardware. Now click finish to reboot your Mac. Log in with your password. Now we need to update Apple softwares. So first, let's go ahead and connect to Wi-Fi network. Now go to the Start menu and launch the Apple software update. Now we have got three updates to install. Additionally, if you are planning to use this iCloud for Windows software, select that too and hit Install. Select Accept, select Yes, and it will start installing the required updates. Hit Install. Now click Yes to reboot your Mac. And we are back up. This completes the Windows 10 installation on your Mac using Bootcamp Assistant. Now, how do you reboot into macOS? Well, you just want to click the little system tray on the bottom right corner and then click Bootcamp icon and then click Restart in macOS and hit OK. This should simply reboot your Mac into macOS. But if you're getting error like this, don't worry. Go to Start menu and restart your Mac. And now you need to hold the Option key on your keyboard. Now this will give you an option to boot into macOS or Windows. Use the arrow keys for the selection. You want to select Macintosh HD this time and hit Return key on your keyboard. And there we go. We are back into macOS. Now what if you want to go back to Windows again? Launch System Preferences, select Startup Disk, click on the lock to authenticate the changes with your password, and then you can select Bootcamp Windows instead of Macintosh HD and then click Restart and confirm restart. Now this time it will boot you into Windows. Now before we close, please understand that we need to run Windows Update and this is a little time consuming process. So you want to go to your Start menu and select Settings. Now here you should select Update and Security. Make sure you click on the Windows Update and it's going to check for the latest updates. Now it will start downloading all these updates and this will take a while. So in the meantime, you can tap on this activation option and you can activate your Windows copy. You can either visit the Windows Store and buy a new copy of Windows Home or Windows Pro, or if you have a product key, you can enter it here and activate your Windows. Even if you don't activate Windows, you can still use it with less personalization options. Also, you can consider the Windows Insider program and Microsoft will give you product activation keys for free. But that will send all the information from your PC to Microsoft to make their products better. So you should be aware of that. And this brings me to the end of the video. Before you leave, do check out other useful tutorials on the channel. I'll see you guys in the next one. Till then, take good care of yourself. I'm Vikas, signing off for the day. Thank you so much for watching.